Alright guys, hello everyone. My name is Sumit Chandel, developer advocate on the AdWords API. What I'll be talking about today is mobile best practices, catching up with a moving target. So this is the agenda. The first item is just how important is mobile. So we'll look at that and look at some trends. After covering how important it is, then we'll look at how to set them up using the API. We'll look at targeting campaigns, so how to target mobile campaigns, setting up mobile extensions, using call metrics, which is a new feature introduced in the AdWords front end, and is available to some degree through the API as well. And then finally, mobile campaign performance reporting, and look at how to track performance of these campaigns using the new report service. Okay, so just how important is mobile? The answer is really important. In fact, there is a whole mobile movement going on. Now I'll apologize because I'm about to show you guys a YouTube video which is loaded with marketing terms, and I know that we're mostly engineers here, but there are some really interesting numbers that are presented in that video, so it's somewhat appealing, at least it was to me when I first saw it, so hopefully it's appealing to you guys as well. Getting back to my slightly less interesting slides. So this is a quote from Mary Meeker. Some of you guys might recognize her. She actually wrote the Internet Report back in 1995. And talked about the internet movement and how important e-commerce was going to be and how important it was to get an online presence. She also recently was quoted saying, mobile is ramping faster than any other technology we've seen in the past. So that's a pretty strong statement considering that, you know, she wrote the Internet Report, which itself was a huge movement. So the move to mobile is happening even faster than that. All right, some more interesting stats to share with you guys. So the mobile web is exploding. The graph here shows U.S. mobile queries and the growth that we've seen over the last year. As you can see, the y-axis is indexed, so we don't actually show the exact numbers, but it's just to give an idea of what the trend looks like. And in the last year, we've seen a 4x growth in mobile search queries in the U.S. Another trend we've seen is that mobile internet usage is soon going to surpass desktop internet usage. So it hasn't happened yet, but if current trends continue, we do see that happening in mid-2013. Another interesting data point is mobile allows for constant connectivity. For an average user, on an average day, the usage of internet through a PC or through a mobile device. So you can see around lunchtime when people kind of leave the office, it kind of dips in for desktop usage. That's when mobile actually picks up. Later on in the evening at around 6 p.m., desktop usage again drops off and you see mobile is actually rising and actually surpasses desktop usage near the late hours of the night. Mobile usage also complements desktop. So you can see throughout the week, there are dips on the weekend. You can see throughout that, there's still high or constant mobile usage and spikes wherever desktop drops. Some more interesting data. Actually, this is a really great website, ourmobileplanet.com. We, Google, are a partner of that, and there's other companies as well who provide their data there. This is a graph that I generated from that website, actually. And it's just tracking different actions that users take after performing a local search, and which percentages take what actions. So as you can see, for example, in the US, about 51% of users who perform a local search will end up calling the business afterwards. That kind of speaks both to location extensions for the local search and mobile extensions for the click-to-call, or the call to the business afterwards. All right, so having seen just how important mobile is, now let's talk about how do we set them up. So getting into our main objective. So the first step is targeting campaigns. We actually have criteria now for all the different campaign targets we might want to set. So that's what we're going to do here. So we have a campaign, let's say we just created, and now we want to set the targeting for this campaign. We're going to look at the different targets or criteria objects that we'd want to set on it to properly target this new campaign. The first of which will be the platform. The different platforms are desktop, high-end mobile, and tablet. These now correspond to these criteria, these on the right-hand side in that table there. Well, this is an excerpt from the SOAP that you'd send in a request. So you'd set a criterion type of platform and set the ID to 30,001, that corresponds to the high-end mobile in the previous table we just saw. The stuff in the grayed-out text, that's optional on input, which you'll get back in response. What else might we want to set? The carrier. That's another important target, something that's existed in previous versions and something that has changed now. This is how you'd set it in the new service. So we have different carrier name and country code combinations. This is just a list of some of them. So let's say we were to target NTT Docomo in Japan. The criteria ID there is 70,000. And so similar to our previous criteria type that we set, we have another one that we set that's type carrier. This time the ID is 70,000. And again, the grayed out text is just to show that that's optional on input, which you get back in response. Okay, so we've set the carrier, we've set the platform. What else might we set? Operating system version. So this is currently how we're exposing the different mobile OSs that we can target. This might actually expand to desktops as well and different operating systems you can target there. For the time being, this is the only platforms you have there, Android, iOS, and Palm. Let's say we're going to target Android. So in this case, we also have the criteria type that we're going to set. This time the type is operating system version, and then the ID we pass in there is 630159 that corresponds to Android. Next, let's set up mobile extensions. So a mobile extension, like a location extension, which I also strongly recommend to use, allows you to provide a fifth line of text to the text size that you serve and provide that extra line there to the bottom with a phone number to call. So you can set the mobile extension at the campaign level, and then any ads that are living under that will show up with that fifth line if they're served on a mobile device. So let's look at how to do that. This sample is actually using v2011.01 Java client library code. It's going to look exactly almost exactly the same in the new version. So it's the example is still useful here. So we create the mobile extension. We set the phone number. This is a 514 number. Country code, and finally a boolean to set is call only. It controls whether or not you want the text ad to show up with it with the ability to click through to your web page or only click the call. So in this case, if it's set is call only to false, it means that the user has both options. They could see the ad and click through to your website, or they can actually click and call. If that was set to true, they could only call. Next we create the generic campaign ad extension. And we set the campaign ad extension to the mobile extension, which we just created. And then finally, we create our operation. We set operand, the operator, and then make the mutate call at the bottom and get our result back. Okay, so using call metrics. It's a number that we actually generate on our side, and that we can put in as a click-to-call number for your ads, so we can basically generate call metrics for you. We can know how many users have called, how long have the calls lasted, how many missed calls do you have, all that kind of information. So currently, call metrics can only be set through the UI, and it only targets US and Canada for the time. There are plans eventually to expose it through the API, and that will be through the mobile extension through a flag that you can set there to specify whether or not you want to use your own number, and in cases where you're using your own kind of call tracking, you might want to do that, or if you'd like to use call metrics and have us auto-generate the number and place it into your mobile extension. So this is just a screenshot of what it looks like if you want to set this in the UI. Okay. A bit more info about call metrics is the pricing. So the way it works, if a user does clicks and calls, it'll basically get charged the same CPC that you bid. The only time that's not the case is if the user calls a number directly without clicking. They just see the number and pick up their landline phone and then dial the number. That's going to be a one US dollar charge. Now, how do we track performance of these campaigns that we're running? We do that in the same way we do for all reporting. We set up our report definition that we'll pass in the request payload, where we're basically selecting a bunch of different fields. So we're selecting date, campaign ID, ad ID, and so forth, clicks, click type, that's an important one, and device as well as one of the additional fields. And then we have predicates to filter on the fields that we selected. Those predicates will be on the click type. So this will help us isolate calls, basically click to calls to isolate our mobile campaigns. And then an extra predicate there, which isn't completely necessary. If you filter on click type array, you basically isolated it, but you can also filter on device for high-end mobile only. That way the reports you get back are strictly for your mobile campaigns. All right. Next is reporting on call metrics. For that, we've actually, with the v2011.09 release, we've included some new columns in the report service specifically for call metrics. That's the ones that you see here. So call duration seconds, average call duration seconds, number of calls, number of missed calls, number of received calls. You can imagine that as you know this call metrics feature matures, there'll be other fields here as well that you might be able to get out. For the moment, this is what's available. So this is what you can include in your report definitions as selectable fields to report on your call metrics. And an important note about this is that colometrics reporting is only available at the campaign level. But there's a very good reason why it isn't set up that way, and we can only do it at the campaigns. We don't have enough numbers to represent the number of ads that we're showing. Okay, any other questions? All right, cool.